Summer is a grueling time of year for gardeners as poison ivy grows and grows out of control, spreads very quickly, and the last thing you want is for it to spread on your skin. I'm not allergic, so I'm going to show you a few tips and kind of climb in with the poison ivy here to show you what to look for if you're outdoors this summer, because the last thing you want is to be stuck indoors for about 2 to 3 weeks suffering from that nasty rash. So here's a quick look at an example of poison ivy found right here just outside the studio. And one thing to look for, of course, is the three leaves. And we've got our first example here. We've got 1, 2, 3 leaves. But also, poison ivy grows left to right. So you can see on the stem here, left and then right, and then left, and we've got a new one coming up here that's gonna be going to the right. So that's something you also wanna look for. It never grows side to side across from one another, and it never has any thorns, so that's something to look at too. Here's an example of a vine that has a thorn. You can see in there, definitely not poison ivy, as that would be something completely different with those thorns on the stem there. But also, here's another one that grows left to right, but notice it has 5 leaves. So we could rule this one out as well, not poison ivy. So those are the quick things you need to look for. But also, if you do come in contact with that nasty oil that is associated with the poison ivy, you have very little time to get it off. About 30 minutes is what time you have to get that oil off your skin. Make sure you use cold water to wash that oil off with a very strong water pressure. Scrub it off, and hot water is a big no-no, only because that will open your pores and allow that oil to get in your skin. So treat yourself, and also calamine lotion is a must too if you do end up getting that rash, but seek medical attention. If you are allergic and you get that rash, best thing is to get treated.